While addressing the media today at the weekly security briefing, police spokesperson Fred Enanga revealed that a group of criminals, with the help of Stanbic officials, forged documents of Nile Energy Company Limited's director and stole $1.8 million, which is approximately 6.5 billion shillings.
Including a banker, have been arrested by our Special Investigations Division in coordination with the Fraud Department at Stanbic Bank, Uganda. And these are scheduled to appear before the Anti-Corruption Division in Kololo in connection with a series of computer system intrusions which gave them unauthorized access to a client's account, where they made unauthorized transfers of funds amounting to $1.8 million into other bank accounts established solely for the purpose of receiving the stolen funds.
Those arrested are 12 in number. They include the manager of Stanbic Bank, Garden City Branch, and the manager of Freedom City Branch. It is said the suspects had opened different bank accounts on which they transferred the stolen money from the Nile Energy Company bank account.
Suspects, in conspiracy with selected bank staff at Garden City and Freedom City branches, opened the three accounts in the names of Dickson Kagurusi Ampumoza, and then another account number in the names of Petrom Limited, and a third account number in the names of Famane Investments Company Limited. And after compromising the account of Nile Energy Company Limited, they transferred, they made the transfers to these three accounts. So more than six withdrawals were made of $495,000, $287,000, $295,000, $90,000, $60,000, $295,000, and $495,000.
Meanwhile, the Ministry of Internal Affairs and the Immigration Department are currently stuck with over 20,000 uncollected passports. Simon Peter Mundei, the ministry spokesperson, revealed that their passport collection centers at Chambogo, Gulu, Mbale, and Mbarara do not have enough storage space, yet they continue to produce 3,000 passports per day.
We have noted that the problem could be because applicants do not receive the SMS messages, some of them informing them to collect their passports, because most likely of two reasons. One, some applicants put incorrect numbers, telephone numbers on their applications, and the commonest problem has been replacing zero with O. Instead of putting zero, in the case of like 0772, some applicants put O772, so the system is not able to send them messages, because it will treat O as a letter, not a figure.
Last week, over 15 passport brokers were arrested. Mundei has warned the public against using brokers while applying for immigration services.
We do appeal to Ugandans who are looking for passports not to involve brokers, because the system has been simplified. It is easy. It is very user-friendly. So you do this by yourselves. All our services, of course, easy to access, and the procedures are very clear for one to use. A passport is something that we have simplified, and we do not expect anybody to be fleeced.
Also, traffic police say reckless driving continues to be the leading cause of road crashes in the country, with at least 152 people killed in these crashes in the last 2 weeks.
We've realized that 90% of these crashes all involved motorcycles. So motorcycle riders, please, we urge you to ride with caution on the road.
Last month, the police reinstated the driver's badges and route charts to all bus operators after registering frequent road crashes involving buses on several highways. Traffic police have warned on a crackdown on bus drivers without badges and route charts. Report by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.